wolves from conflict to coexistence. A documentary produced with the support of the European Commission through the Life Nature Programme. Due to its special geographical features, Romania is one of the few European regions where the environment has remained in good condition. Apart from wetlands, forest habitats play a critical role in maintaining a good environmental status in Romania. The 7 million hectares of forests host over 1,300 species of plants and animals, including many protected or strictly protected species. The Carpathian Mountains are among the largest unfragmented forested areas. Over 65% of Romania's alpine region is covered by spruce and beech forests. Furthermore, here, the surface of virgin forests is the highest in Europe. These forests provide shelter for large carnivore species that have become extinct from the vast majority of Western European countries, mainly due to the loss of natural habitats and conflicts with humans. The brown bear is the largest terrestrial predator in Europe. Despite the capacity to adapt to environmental changes, the brown bear population has dramatically decreased over the past 100 years. Without considering the forest habitats in Russia, the number of bears in Europe is estimated to be around 14,000. More than half of the European population lives in the woods of the Carpathian region. In the past, the wolf was considered the greatest enemy of livestock breeders and gamekeepers. During the communist era, the wolf was subjected to a systematic eradication program with all its means. Until the early 1970s, the wolf population was reduced to just 1,600 individuals. However, due to the protection measures in recent decades, the number of wolves is slightly increasing, the wildlife ecologists estimating a population between 2,000 and 2,500 individuals. The information about the status of the lynx population in Romania is scarce. The lynx is a shy species and in need of an extensive area for survival. We assume that its population was not very large in the past, but this is only a guess, as the observation and evaluation of this species is a challenge. At present, the lynx population in Romania may be between 1,200 and 1,500, which is a significant number, taking into account that the size of the entire European population is estimated at 9,000 to 10,000 individuals. Conservation of large carnivore species is our legal and moral obligation, but unfortunately, it is an increasingly difficult task. The last decades have brought radical changes in the economy of Romania. The intensive use of natural resources leads to major changes in the landscape. The wood industry requires large quantities of raw material, the export of logs and timber growing considerably. In many cases, extraction of mineral resources has reduced the size of wooded areas. Accession to the European Union contributed to the dramatic growth in livestock production, primarily through massive subsidies for farmers. The number of sheep reached 9 million in 2017, a large number of flocks not being served by trained staff. Traditional zootechnical practices are abandoned and gradually forgotten. Lately, there have been intense debates about the maximum allowed number of livestock guard dogs per flock. Some argue in favor of many dogs per flock to prevent losses caused by large carnivores, while others show the environmental damage caused by these dogs. The problem is still the subject of lively debates. As a result of increasing standards of living, more and more people can afford to spend their free time in nature. Tourism development creates new sources of income for investors. New adventure parks and ski slopes are open every year, the mountain area never attracting so many visitors as it is now. The popularity of motorsports is gradually increasing. Nowadays, it is common to see an off-road motorbike or all-terrain vehicle in the forest. Economic development is not possible without infrastructure. To serve the needs of transporting goods and people, it is necessary to continuously expand or upgrade the road network. Increased traffic leads to more victims on the roads, including wildlife. Increased transport needs can only be met by building new highways. These developments affect significant areas, and habitat fragmentation is the most critical. The protective fences, the high-speed carriageway, are absolute barriers to many wildlife species, their habitats being divided into small fragments. The connectivity between these fragments is lost, and thus the genetic quality of the isolated populations decreases rapidly. Changes in landscape have a negative effect on fauna, conflicts between humans and wildlife are becoming more frequent and dangerous. The image of brown bears feeding on garbage cans is no longer an unusual picture in Böyle Tushnad, Balvanyos, and other localities in the country. The efforts done by gamekeepers, public authorities, or non-governmental organizations to handle the situation have no effect or present just a temporary solution to the conflicts. In recent years, the damages produced by brown bears have increased. From April to November or December, hundreds of sheep, cattle, and bee families are killed by brown bears. Damages to crops and orchards are also significant. The number of livestock killed by wolves is limited, but attacks may still impact livestock breeders. Mass killing is a behavioral characteristic of wolves, so a single mass killing event can compromise the profit of a livestock breeder for a year. For hunting grounds administrators, each deer or wild boar is a potential source of revenue, hence, they consider the game predated by large carnivores as a material loss. Many people believe that these species are harmful for nature and their conservation must only be solved in zoos or closed parks. Or even worse, they try to solve the conflicts on their own by poaching the large carnivores, killing the animals, or putting other people in hazardous situations. Is it true that large carnivores are the biggest problem for farmers? Are wolves the ultimate enemy of livestock breeders, as was claimed during the communism, even by scientists? Is it possible to have a balanced coexistence between humans and large carnivores by keeping damage at a tolerable level? The answer to these questions can only be given by a scientific approach following detailed studies. For these reasons, in 2014, with the support of the European Union, the first project devoted exclusively to the wolf was launched. The project aimed to preserve the conservation status of wolves in Romania and to manage the conflicts between humans and wildlife. Through the Wolf Life Project, the teams of environmental protection agencies in Harghita, Covasna and Vrancea counties, as well as a non-governmental organization, foreign experts and volunteers, tried to find answers to the wolf question. How large is the national population? Are there more effective ways to count the number of wolves? Can the extent of the damages be considerably reduced? Answers can only be given after a thorough bibliographic study, as well as after many hours spent on the field. And the most suitable time for field work is when winter arrives. Assessments were made on pilot areas of 9 to 12,000 hectares from 6 counties within Romania. Following repeated field trips, the project team traveled on foot over 5,500 kilometers, recording all traces and signs indicating the presence of wolves. Recognition of wolf trail on the field is quite difficult, as this is very much like the trail of a big dog. Further information can be obtained by examining the tracks. The step length, the position of the fingerprints, the movement characteristics of the animal are all necessary to confirm the presence of a wolf. In order to determine the number of individuals, it is vital to track the pack over long distances, as the animals that move in line often follow each other's steps. Contrary to previous knowledge, the size of the Carpathian packs does not equal the size of a pack in northern areas. Generally, a pack of wolves from the Carpathians includes only 4 to 5 individuals. The largest recorded pack included 11 members. A wolf pack uses a territory of 10 to 15,000 hectares for hunting on a regular basis. This vast territory is protected against other wolf packs. That is why most signs of presence are found at the boundary between two neighboring territories. The border of pack territory are marked by wolves with urine. These olfactory markings provide information for other wolves and wildlife, but they are also important for scientists evaluating the packs. Based on the genetic material in the urine, it is possible to individually identify the wolf specimens. Samples of scats may also provide additional information for researchers. The wolf diet can be assessed based on the content of scat, but this can also provide biological material for genetic analysis. Remote cameras can make the evaluation of animal numbers easier. These remote cameras, positioned on wolves' routes, are capable of recording the animal's image day and night for several days. Prey bodies found on the ground can also contribute to the evaluation of the population, but they also provide information on species that constitute the wolf prey. Unlike cats that attack from an ambush, a wolf prey is hunted down after a long run. During the winter, the whole pack takes part in the well-organized hunt. In summer, wolves prey mainly on small species, rodents, birds, or small mammals. During this period, the wolves hunt in small groups of about 2 individuals. Evaluating the size of wolf packs can also be done by identifying breeding pairs. In a wolf pack, no matter how big it is, one single female can have cubs. Locating the breeding grounds is one of the most difficult research activities. The den is placed in the most hidden, inaccessible part of the pack territory. After 9 weeks of gestation, 3 to 7 pups are born blind and helpless the entire pack taking care of them. In October or November, the cubs are able to follow the pack at the hunt, during which the wolf movement area is much extended. In this part of the year, they can also appear near inhabited areas, causing damage to sheep from yards and gardens. The most iconic feature of wolves is their howling. Although many believe that wolves howl at the full moon, these sounds have a complex communication role. The howl, together with the urine markers, are important means to avoid direct contact between neighboring packs, and thus they can also be used in the evaluation of individual numbers. The pack responds to the howl reproduced by audio equipment or even imitated by scientists, thus revealing the location and number of members. The processing of collected data is far less interesting than fieldwork, but it is equally important. Raw data from GPS devices are transferred to geographic databases, processing and visualization being done through specialized applications. Overlaying processed data with base maps can provide a clearer picture of the presence and movements of wolves. Images captured by remote cameras can provide valuable data for experts, although most of the records are species other than the wolf. With some luck, based on these images, aspects of wolves' social behavior can also be captured. As an example, in these images, the pack renews the urine markers on the border of its territory. Performing genetic analysis requires high-tech labs and is a fairly expensive process, but it can provide information that cannot be obtained by any other means. It is possible to identify the individuals in the pictures, as well as to map the kinship relations between individuals. Laboratory activities include the evaluation of collected wolves' scats. By counting hair and bone fragments left after washing the samples, the composition of food debris and the wolf's diet is revealed. Our studies confirmed the information from other sources according to which, in our area, the most important prey for wolves is the wild boar. The wild boar is a very prolific species, but the majority of piglets do not survive the first winter. The body size of this species makes it a favored prey for the wolves. In addition to the wild boar, the favorite preys for wolves are the roebuck in hilly areas and the deer in mountain areas. The wolves predate mostly on young, weakened, sick, or elderly animals. In mountain areas, the Carpathian chamois could be the prey to the wolf. But catching these animals is not easy, even for the quick and agile wolf. The European bison, the largest herbivorous species in Europe, recently reintroduced in Romania, could be prey for wolves, but because of the body size and social behavior of the herd, the species is mostly inaccessible for the tiny wolf packs of 4 or 5 members of our country. Our analysis confirmed that the sheep and goat ratios in the wolf diet were below 5% in all study areas. Thus, losses caused by this species are much lower than those estimated by farmers. During the communist era, when the wolf was considered the ultimate pest, some publications estimated this percentage at 75%. Surprisingly, 4 to 12% of the wolf's prey is the domestic dog. The roots of this unique phenomenon in Europe come from inadequate dog keeping practices and especially in the extremely high number of stray dogs in the forests. This large number has been confirmed both by field trips and by images recorded by remote cameras. Data from different assessment methods confirmed the results, providing a close-up picture of the size of the wolf population and the spatial distribution of the territories. Although no large-scale study has been carried out within the project, many results can be considered as generally valid for Romania. Among these, the most important thing is that it has been clarified. The official reports overestimate the size of the wolf population. This is mainly due to multiple counts of a wolf pack caused by long-distance movements. Genetic analysis has shown that pack stability is much lower than in other European countries, probably because of hunting and poaching. Killing one member of the breeding pair creates an imbalance in the structure of the pack being reorganized, often divided into several breeding pairs. There was an interesting case of animal movement between packs. A young wolf who grew up in a pack in Vrancea County found a new family in South Harghita after a journey of more than 80 kilometers. This highlights the importance of maintaining permeability between habitats. The main condition of human cohabitation with wolves is to maintain the damage to a tolerable level. Studies have shown that the incidence of damages are not directly related to the number of wolves in an area, but instead correlates with the number of natural prey of wolves and livestock practices used in the region. From this point of view, our country is in a favorable situation, the zootechnical practices being under the constant pressure of the predators. Traditional techniques are therefore able to keep losses at a low level. The continued presence of stuff near the livestock, corrals, proper use of guard dogs, are traditional practices that have survived in the mountain areas. And the Wolf Life Project assessed their efficiency and encouraged their use during the meetings with livestock farmers as well as in informative materials. The level of livestock losses can also be reduced by encouraging the use of modern damage prevention techniques and electric fence systems. These defending systems do not require large investment. They can be installed anywhere and maintained by anyone. Experiences have confirmed that they can effectively prevent attacks by both wolves and bears. It is very important to accurately identify the damages caused by domestic animals, especially dogs. These damages should not be attributed to wolves. In this project, the personnel was trained and endowed with equipment useful to assess the damages. Correct identification of the predator is not easy in all cases, but the guide developed in the project can help the evaluators. The studies showed that the wolf's conservation status is also influenced by the way we behave with our domestic wolves, the dogs. The large number of stray dogs are a food source for wolves, but they also present a threat to them. It is important to use appropriate guard dogs to successfully defend the flocks. The use of any modern dog breeds does not only prevent damages, but can also be a real danger for domestic animals, wildlife, and people. Promoting the use of traditional dog breeds is a task adopted by the Wolf Life Project. Puppies of the Romanian Carpathian Shepherd breed from certified kennel breeders have been donated to those livestock breeders who have undertaken to raise them and use them properly. Livestock breeders are required to donate the puppies from those dogs to other households in the area, thus contributing to the increase of this valuable dog breed. In addition to the damages caused by wolves, its negative image is also maintained by the fact that most people do not have adequate knowledge of their role and ecological importance. Western European states understood the importance of large carnivores only after their eradication. Only then was it understood how vital these species are in maintaining the herbivorous herds at an optimum size or in preventing the spread of contagious diseases. These roles cannot be replaced by human intervention. The very complex relationships between predators and prey are only being deciphered at the moment, but it is clear that the wolf does have its place in every healthy and long-term sustainable ecosystem. Besides its ecological role, the wolf is part of our culture. As with other peoples, the wolf is present in our history, traditions, and fairy tales, forming for thousands of years the image we have about the world surrounding us. Last but not least, we owe him our dearest and faithful companion, the dog.